fine now, demiguys. Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade. Alohomora. I wonder who lives here. Leviosa. Hello, nice to meet you.
Welcome, I'm Bernard Indiaye, and this is my shop. Is there anything I can help you with?
What do you have for sale?
A pleasure doing business with you. Mentioned you're welcome to stop by any time.
Mind now, demiguys. It's like a place right out of a storybook.
An intruder! Enjoy suffering!
There we go. Seems a pleasant enough little place. I wonder who lives here. This looks like
true. You want to talk brave?
Lisa, pull!
What was that sound?
Deke?
Ah, Deke is so happy to see you. Deke noticed this bag in the room the other day. You must need it to help with your schoolwork. Deke has seen one of these before. Deke calls it a knapsack. Perfect for gathering and transporting beasts. Pleasant little breeze.
I have been thinking about something Professor Howin said in Beasts class, that I should study as many beasts as I can, on my own time. She also mentioned that poachers have been active in the area, so perhaps the beasts will be safer with us than out there on their own.
Precisely what Deke was thinking. You see, the room knew exactly what you needed, and luckily, Deke can show you how to best use the knapsack and where. Come along, then. Our first stop will be beyond the castle grounds. We can leave now, or you can come and find Deke when you're...
I'm ready to learn how to use the knapsack.
Perfect! Deke loves an outing. A nasty poacher. Deke hated working for him. He did horrible things to beautiful beasts. Oh. It was during those days that Deke first saw a knapsack. It'll be nice to see one used for good.
Accio.
We have arrived. Deke enjoys coming here to watch the beasts, especially the Puffle of Puffskeens nearby. It will be nice to keep them safe. All you will need to do is get close, direct the open knapsack toward the Puffskeen, and in it'll go.
All right. I managed to rescue a Puffskeen.
You can rescue as many as the knapsack will hold. Poachers capture Puffskeens and, well, Deke isn't sure what they do with them. Deke is certain they will be safer with you. Now, not all beasts will be as simple to rescue as a Puffskeen. Deke suggests you next find a beast that can fly. A Jobbernoll, perhaps.
All right. Where would I find one?
Deke knows of some to the west, nesting in a large tree overlooking Hogwarts. But we must be careful. Deke has seen poachers in the area recently. Deke will meet you there whenever you're ready.
Ha. Ha. I'll look after you.
Yeah.
Incendio! Hello, Deke. Shall we continue?
Oh, good. Deke was worried about you, what with all the poachers in the area. Perhaps we should work quickly. The jobbernauls are just here, in this large tree. If it's helpful, Deke has seen Levioso used to slow flying beasts. Easier to get in close and use the knapsack.
Then I shall go and rescue a jobbernaul.
Good luck. Deke will be waiting.
Don't. Difficult, I mean you no harm. I'm only trying to help. I rescued a jobbernaul.
Deke hopes your jobbernaul finds the knapsack nice and cozy. Poachers want them for their feathers, and are not kind when they gather them.
Are there any other beasts nearby?
Just one that Deke knows of, a herd of moon calves. They live in a clearing of trees up this footpath. Deke will see you there.
Furiosa. Hello, Deke. Is this the clearing you mentioned?
It is. Moon calves gather near the large tree with the spiral pattern in front, but only under the light of the moon. So, unfortunately, unless you have a way to hasten time, you might sometimes have to wait until nightfall to see them.
I shall go and find a moon calf then.
Deke will be waiting for your return.
Deke, what am I meant to be doing again?
You...
Oh, no, you don't. Do cooperate, won't you? No need to be difficult. I mean you no harm. It was a bit trickier than the others, but I have a moon calf now.
Another beast, safe and sound. Shame we didn't see the moon calves dancing. It's a marvellous sight. Deke supposes you're finished here. He'll be able to rescue many more beasts, but for now, let's bring the ones you've gathered back to the room.
All right.
Deke will meet you back in the room whenever you're ready. There you are. Now, we need to show the beast you rescued, then you home. But, not enough room to let them out here. Imagine all those beasts running amok. That wouldn't do at all. Perhaps if you focus on what your beasts need, the room will provide. What exactly did you think of? Heavens! You've done it!
But what is it?
Deke isn't sure. Only one way to find out. Meet you inside when you're ready. Look at this! It's amazing!
Where are we, Deke?
It seems to be a place for your beasts to live, a vivarium of some sort. Oh, your beasts will be quite comfortable here. They'll live healthy, safe lives. Perhaps you want to release them, let them see their new home. Thinks the vivarium will be a fitting new home for your beasts.
Indeed. I only hope we'll have enough space for all of them.
Deke hopes so too. But if you do run out of room, Madam Peck at Brood and Peck in Hogsmeade will help to find safe homes for them.
Any beasts the room can't hold?
Yes, she's well known for helping to care for beasts in need, and she'll give you a fair price for them. Speaking of care, beasts that are well-fed and groomed will provide you with valuable magical materials, such as puffskein hair, for example. If you gather some magical materials from your beasts, Deke can show you how to use them.
Very well. I shall let you know when I have some.
Deke thinks you are doing good work here.
I've collected some magical materials, Deke.
Now Deke can show you how to use them. First, you'll need to use this spellcraft to conjure an enchanted loom.
An enchanted loom?
Exactly. It will allow you to use your magical materials to weave magic into the very threads of your clothing, making your clothing more useful in a variety of ways. Why don't you try it? Deke thinks you'll be impressed with what the loom can do.
I'll go and experiment with the loom now. Came out nicely. I should show Deke. I used the enchanted loom, Deke.
Wonderful.
Will I be able to weave even more powerful magic into my clothing with the loom?
You will, by rescuing even more powerful beasts. For now, however, Deke suggests you explore the vivarium and get to know the beast you've already rescued.
Thank you for your help, Deke.
We were merely musing on the state of a...
Welcome back. Have you finished your assignment?
Reporting back, Professor. Assignment's all finished.
Well done. Shows good discipline. Wisdom is a golden snitch, as they say. And you're proving a skilled seeker. Let us practice our restore momentum. A charm, incidentally, created to stop Quaffles from plummeting straight to the ground during a Quidditch match. Precise, deliberate movements. Very good.
Arrest the rest.
That's it. Keep it up.
Professor, do you have a moment? In class, I heard you mention the Toyohashi Quidditch team.
I did. The Toyohashi Tengu are from Japan. Dominant. Known for their rigorous training. They practice near the Mahutokoro School of Magic, often battling both tempestuous seas and violent storms, in addition to each other. Tournament play is almost always easier for the Tengu than their training sessions.
I take it you're a fan.
Fan? I was being groomed to play on their team. And I would have been a Tengu, if not for a bit of bad luck.
If you were that good, I can't believe a bit of bad luck could end your entire Quidditch career.
I was excellent. My ability on a broom had nothing to do with what happened. I was betrayed by someone I trusted. Myself. I did not see clearly and I paid a dear price. My best friend Asuka and I were being groomed to play on the team together. I as keeper and she as chaser. She was breathtaking. She once corkscrewed through three players and scored before they even turned their heads. But as tryouts for the Tengu got closer, she panicked. I did not realize the extent of her panic until it was too late. She wanted so desperately for both of us to play together that she had slipped Felix Felicis into our tea before we were to show them our skills.
Liquid luck? That's illegal, isn't it?
It is indeed. I knew within minutes that something was different. I had never played so well. And Asuka was playing more beautifully than I had ever seen. When I confronted her afterwards, she admitted what she had done. I withdrew from consideration immediately.
But it wasn't your fault. You didn't know about the potion in the tea.
It does not matter. My flying that day was not my own. I could not live with myself. So, I withdrew and explained to them why. I burned my broom in disgrace.
What happened to Asuka? Did she burn her broom as well?
Asuka played for the Tengu for 2 seasons.
You didn't report her? Tell them what she'd done.
Her fate was not mine to decide. My fate is in my hands, as your fate is in yours.
Thank you, Professor. I shall remember what you've told me.